So that's where space starts. But where does it end? To find out, we're taking a trip to the farthest reaches of the universe. For our first stop, we're heading to the edge of our solar system.
Sweet hat, right? I've always wanted to be a star. Get it? The point is, have you ever noticed whenever you see images of the solar system, the planets are always grouped into one shot? Kinda gives the impression that the sun and planets are relatively close to each other. Oh, but I can assure you they're not.
Even on the fastest spacecraft ever, it would take you 36 years to get to the edge of our solar system. That's a lot of...
Are we there yet?
Now, our next stop is way out there, so we'll need to travel at the speed of light.
All right, let's take this bucket of bolts into hyperspace. Warp speed, baby. Punch it.
I know, that's how every space movie and TV show does hyperspace. But there's no way it would actually look like that. According to Einstein's theory of special relativity, hurtling through space at the speed of light would make the wavelengths of light appear shorter, not longer. So how should it look? It would probably look a lot more like this.
That looks really exciting.
It hasn't been invented yet. I guess we can let it slide. To travel across our entire galaxy, the Milky Way, it would take you 100,000 years. Hope your spaceship has some good entertainment. And now for your biggest leap yet. We're leaving our galaxy and traveling across the whole known universe. At light speed, it would take you 93 billion years, and you'd pass hundreds of billions of other galaxies along the way. Hey, galaxies.
Hi.
Hey, hello.
What's up?
The universe isn't just huge, it's literally everything. There are more stars in the universe than there are grains of sand on Earth. And each one of those billions and billions of stars is thought to have at least